Okay, we have another work from the very prolific Ahmed Khan, who has donated this task one. I love task one writing. I think it's fun. It's a puzzle, really, and it can be formulaic, meaning you just need to put together the pieces, but you got to determine what the pieces are first. I know it's rather abstract, but it's not as simple as some other mentors try to make it sound, like just find the highest and lowest and just use that. I'm a big proponent of looking deeper at the charts. Okay, so what do we have here? We have energy used in an average Australian household. When? Doesn't say when. And here the second one shows the greenhouse gas emissions. That's going to be hard to paraphrase. Which result from this energy use. And it's in percentages. So here's how much energy the house uses, and I mean in percentage of the total use by the house, and here's the impact of that use on greenhouse gases. Now, why does some energy produce more greenhouse gases than other energy? I don't know, but that's not important. And let's see what Mr. Khan has to say. Okay, and once again, a blue is coherence and cohesion, your connectors and the flow. Yellow is vocabulary. Red is task response. It should be task achievement, different than task response. And green is grammar. Okay. Out of the two given pie charts. Out of the two. Now I don't. Of the two would be better. Out of the two means you're picking one, and then you forgot your comma here. The first one showcases. Showcase is a business English term, really, more than anything else, and it's used to highlight something, to bring it to people's attention in a positive way. You know, we're going to showcase our latest products. So showcases does not fit here. The energy expenditure. Expenditure is only used with money. Or resources to a certain extent, but no, that doesn't fit either. Expended or used, don't be afraid to use some of the words from the chart. Some, not all of them. On various uses by a usual house in Australia. I don't think that's a good synonym for average. Normal would be better. Okay, Australia spelled wrong. Whereas the second one, second chart illustrates fine greenhouse by this power usage. Okay, now here's the most important part, is the overview. And before you do your overview, you want to take some time to analyze the chart and look for a way that you can divide it into two, and look for ways that you can combine categories into larger categories, which will allow you to describe them more efficiently. The whole point of task one, it says here, summarize the information, which means to make the important information, to relate it in as few words as possible. And to do that, you want to combine, okay? Summarize, choosing and reporting the main features, not all the features, just the main features, and make comparisons. All right, so I look at this, and what jumps out? Well, you know, here we have two big chunks. The two biggest chunks both have the word heating in them. Heating is, here it means household heating, which, you know, a lot of us who live here in tropical climates don't even know what that is. Yes, it takes energy to keep the house warm. And water heating. Well, we can combine those two easily. And then these two are also very combinable. What is a refrigerator? It is an appliance. So other appliances means other than refrigerators. So those are easily combined. And here, okay, big chunk. Oh, much less than half. Oh, I like how it's just less than half. That's nice. And what could have happened here? Ooh, 22%, 42%. So it seems obvious when you take some time to look at it that our overview should be quite simple, that the energy used for heating was the highest. But it had a much smaller impact on the greenhouse gases. Whereas the opposite is true, making a comparison for appliances. which used a smaller amount of energy, but then significantly more impact on greenhouse gases. Let's see if Mr. Kahn caught that. Overall, it is evident the most energy was used for heating purposes. Okay, oh, I read that and I go, all right, yes. Are you combining those two or just saying that one? And it is also responsible for the most gas emissions. No, it is not. Okay, yes, it is if you combine the two categories. The most here, and yes, it's still the most if you combine that. But I think you're saying heating, and yes, it says heating. Since you didn't combine them, 15%. Is that the most gas emissions? No, it's not. Followed similarly by other appliances. What do you mean there? It's third here. And, well, yeah, it's unclear. And first of all, you can't have other appliances before you have some appliances. It's, what do you mean by other than what? Oh, see, the thing with a task one is that if it's done correctly, a person reading it should be able to recreate the chart to a significant, level of accuracy based upon what they're reading. And so, yes, it does say other appliances there, but in just in general English, I don't know what you mean by that. Okay, this kind of word, from an analysis of the chart, of the first chart, it can be seen, we need a comma there. That's a stock phrase. It can be seen that although you use that phrase for the overview, that although energy utilized for heating, I guess utilized, I don't know why I put a green there, it's fine. Was, missing word, this is a superlative, you need the greatest. I think my food is here. Hello? Oh, okay. It's gas exhaustion. Well, what gas? Greenhouse gases. You could say emissions, but not just gas. And exhaustion is the noun form of exhausted, meaning really tired. The noun form of exhaust as a verb is exhaust. Was less than half that value of 15%? No. When you say of, they're saying 15% is this value. It should say half that value at 15%. The opposite is true for refrigeration. That is fine. That produced double the proportion of greenhouse gases than its energy use. Okay, that's fair. The energy used for heating water was one third of the total. No, you need to be accurate. The energy used for heating water was 30%. That's less than a third. Slightly less than a third, you can say that. While, interestingly, it emitted a little over this amount in greenhouse gas emissions. Well, remember, you want to be precise here. The water heating is not emitting greenhouse gases. The energy needed to heat the water is produced, and the production of that energy is what emits the greenhouse gases, not the this. So it didn't emit this, the energy did. And why was? Why not is? Oh, yeah, was all over the place. See any time in here? There's no time. It's is used, is present tense. It should all be in the present tense, not the past tense. And the reason why that's red is because it's part of the question. So once again, we have inaccurate facts. The other appliances. What other? Oh, I guess you mentioned refrigeration up here, but But appliances other than refrigerators are responsible for almost one-third of greenhouse, one word, gases produced. But their power usage was half of that at 15%. Well, at least you got almost one-third here. Wait, okay, no, it's 28%. It's a little over a quarter. And it's more than half. It's not half. These are important numbers. You can't just guess. You can't just, oh, it's close enough. No, it's inaccurate. A similar pattern, oh, look, now we're changing into the present tense, is followed by lighting. Cooling, on the other hand. Well, what is this pattern followed by lighting? You don't tell us anything about it. Cooling, on the other hand. Compared to what? Made 3% of greenhouse, while used energy equal to 2%. This is, when I said at the beginning, report the main information, the most important information. This here, all of this, is not important information. And you're making weird comparisons that I don't understand. On the other hand, and for fun, let's look at a model answer. Okay, this is a model answer. There are two pie charts which show how Australian homes use energy. The first divides average household usage into six categories, and the second illustrates the carbon footprint of each category. Some good paraphrasing. Overall, it can be clearly seen that the two thermal usages, thermal means heating, water heating and general household heating, combine to account for a large majority of energy use, but their impact on total greenhouse gas emissions is significantly less. Conversely, making a comparison, the percentage of emissions, should be an S there, from home appliances, that's combining other and refrigerators, we can combine those together and call them home appliances, were nearly double the proportion of their energy use. And then I've got the details. I won't go into it. You can read it yourself. We're bringing out the numbers, but here's what's important. You'll note my overview is divided into two halves. Here's the first main feature, what happened with heating. Here's the second main feature, what happens with appliances. This paragraph is about heating. This paragraph is about appliances. And then, there's a little room, I'm only at 184, there's one little tiny bit. In addition, relatively small amounts of energy is used for lighting and cooling. You don't even need any details there. So, as a band scorer, you have an overview, and it is appropriately selected information, so that'll get you a 6. C&C, there's some clunkiness in here, but it's not so horrible, I'd give it a 7. There's too many mistakes with lexical to give you a 7, so it'll be a 6, and then a 7 with grammar, so about 6.5, I'd say, on this, in my amateur opinion. Okay, Mr. Khan, I hope this helps. I hope it's not too late, and good luck with your test.